Hi guys, this video covers all the things you need to know about magnetism for your Edexcel physics.
When we have two like poles, they're going to repel. But when we have two unlike poles, they're going to attract. A permanent magnet is going to have a magnetic field which goes from north to south. And we can induce a magnet, a temporary magnet, if we place something inside that magnetic field. Magnetic materials are going to be metals, and that is going to include iron, nickel, and cobalt. You can easily make an electromagnet at home. All you need is a battery, some wire, and an iron nail. Because all an electromagnet is an iron core with a wire around it connected up to a current. You can use this to pick up things like paper clips or iron filings. When a current is passed through the wire, it creates a magnetic field around the wire, and this in turn strongly magnetises the iron bar, thus creating our electromagnet. If you want to change the strength of an electromagnet, you can do two things. You can change the current, or you change the number of turns or the number of coils that the wire times the wire is wrapped around the iron core.
For Fleming's left hand rule, we need to make our left hand in this shape here. So finger pointing out, thumb up, finger out. And your first finger is your magnetic field. This finger here is the current, and then your thumb is the movement of the force. And what you need to do when you have an exam question is literally you can contort your hand until it fits in the right direction. So first one's nice and easy. My field is going in that direction. My current is going in that direction. So the movement of the force is going upwards. This one here is a bit more complicated because this finger needs to be pointing in that direction. My current needs to be going down, and then my thumb is going into the page.
We can change the size of the force by changing the current. By changing the strength of the magnet. Or by changing the angle between the wire and the magnetic field lines. The greatest force is when the wire is perpendicular with magnetic field lines, and the force is going to be zero if the wire and the field lines are parallel. Magnetic flux density is the amount of magnetic flux in a certain area, and the equation that we use for this is force equals magnetic flux density times current times length. You'll notice, really annoyingly, that this is an uppercase I and a lowercase L. Our units for this, for force, are newtons. For magnetic flux density, they are tesla. For current, it is amps. And for length, that is meters. While this is called a simple electric motor, there's actually quite a lot of physics going on here. And for this, we really need to use our Fleming's left-hand rule. So our magnetic field is going from north to south like this. our current is moving actually in two different directions. On this side, it's moving in this direction, and on the other side, it's moving in this direction. So what we are going to have is that when the wire is moving past the south bit of the magnet, the force is going to be going down, and when it's moving past the north face of the magnet, the force is going to be going up. And because one side is being pushed down, the other side is being pushed up, it is going to turn around. A moving coil loudspeaker works by making a diaphragm attached to a coil vibrate. When we have a current passing through the coil, the force that is generated via the motor effect makes the coil move. Every time the current changes direction, the force reverses direction. So the coil is going to be going back and forwards, making the diaphragm go back and forward, generating sound waves. A moving coil microphone works with the same principle but in the opposite direction. Sound causes the diaphragm to vibrate, the diaphragm is attached to the coil. The vibration of the diaphragm moves the coil, which is going to cause the coil to move backwards and forwards past the magnet.